It's Sunday, and Narwal and Nazra are cooking lunch for their mum and cousin. The Noor family are refugees, and for the last 2 years they've been living in East London, supported by a group of churches, including the Salvation Army. They are safe now and away from danger, but before they arrived here it was a very different story.
I'm originally from Somalia, and I have lived in Syria for almost half of my life. When the war happened, we flee. We couldn't understand what is happening. You have just to search your phone before you go out from your house and see where is happening something. It was, yeah, quite a scary thing to do.
The war in Syria came after 2 decades of uncertainty for the family, moving from country to country, escaping violence and conflict.
You feel like hopeless, and you can't do anything about it. You just feel scared.
Help came when the family applied to the UN for refugee status and were accepted on the community sponsorship scheme backed by the UK government. The family were partnered with a group from East London.
We arrived the 2nd of June 2021. We have been welcomed by 5 or more church, and one of them like the Salvation Army.
Ben Still is from the Salvation Army and leads the group.
When they arrived, we took them to their new home in East London. And seeing their reaction to the house and knowing that this was going to be a place where they could settle and feel safe and secure, that was a really special moment.
We were excited and confused at the same time. We received a lot of gifts, and yeah, it was just amazing. They visit us daily the first week just to process everything.
Oh, hi!
We were surprised from the help we get.
Yeah, because this was a system that it asked us to go through.
They help us with the legal documents and even just to apply for the GB.
This was the one that you had from Lebanon, I think.
Yeah, yeah. It was amazing. It was like you get to know a community. They help us with everything.
As well as leading the Stepney project, Ben is also the Salvation Army's National Refugee Response Manager.
One of our core values in the Salvation Army is compassion, and one of the ways that that works itself out is in our service of refugees. The Salvation Army is recognised by the Home Office as a lead sponsor, and that means that we have a number of groups under our umbrella who are supporting refugee families through community sponsorship. And part of my role is to support those groups. Taking part in this community sponsorship programme gives me a helpful context and understanding of what it's like to lead one of these groups on the ground.
Anyone else want a hot drink while I'm here?
Coffee.
The Salvation Army in Stepney have opened their doors to all refugees in the area and run a fortnightly chatty cafe.
You went to a concert?
It's an informal conversation group for anyone who wants to improve their English.
Hey! Hello.
Hi. Nazra and Nawal are regulars at the group.
Every other Sunday we go there and just we talk about a different subject and just to practice English, because we were not that confident with English.
Is it strawberry?
We have Iranian and Syrian and even Ukraine. We just talk about our countries. There's a lot of people we meet there.
Members of Stepney Salvation Army have been staying on after their morning meeting to join the conversation. People like Belinda.
We all come to London with all of our different stories, all of our different cultures, and how would we meet people when we don't speak the same language, if we don't have the same culture, where else would we connect? One of those things is about food and about community and chatting, and so it's just one of those ways to join the dots.
The family has been here for 2 years now. They see London as their home, and they've become part of the local community. Today, Narwal and her cousin Mohammed are taking part in a gardening project helping some of the older members of the neighbourhood.
We go to the gardening with the Salvation Army. We do like gardening for older people. So and we have just a tea with them and have a chat. So it's a beautiful thing, I think, because sometimes they don't have something to visit and we just help them.
It's been eye-opening to have the opportunity to spend time with people who have a completely different life experience to myself, and to see the perseverance, the joy, the spirit that they have to move forward, to continue, to always have hope that the future is going to be brighter and better, despite everything that they've been through, has been really, really powerful.
I have clear vision for my future now. It was like a fog when I was in Syria. Like now I can think about my future and what I'm gonna do. I want to go to university, and that's make me like a hopeful thing to do. Yeah. I just remember that I'm blessed. Like I just thank God.
Yeah.